right, all right, all right. Okay, okay, okay. Hello, hello to all my Kalolas and to all Lolos, to all mothers and to all my beautiful, amazing viewers and followers. I just want to say thank you for continue watching my YouTube videos, and I just want to give you an update of my garden. As you see, my roses are blooming. So enjoy! I just want to thank God for the joy of gardening. God says, come to me with a teachable spirit, eager to be changed. A close walk with God is a life of continual newness. Do not cling to old ways as we step into a day-by-day life. Instead, seek God's face with an open mind, knowing that our journey with God involves being transformed by the renewing of our mind. As we focus our thoughts on God, be aware that He is fully attentive to us. He sees us with a steady eye because His attention span is infinite. He knows and understands us completely. His thoughts embrace us in everlasting love. He said, I also know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. This is the Bible verse that my late husband gave to me in 1997 when I was newly arrived here in New York, and it ministered to my heart, and I wrote it in the tablet of my heart, and I memorized it and meditated it day and night. God said, give yourself fully to this adventure of increasing attentiveness to His presence. God says, relax in my healing presence. As we spend time with God, our thoughts tend to jump ahead to today's plans and problems. Bring our mind back to Him for refreshment and renewal. Let the light of God's presence soak into us as we focus our thoughts on Him. Thus, He equips us to face whatever the day brings. This sacrifice of time pleases God and strengthens us. Do not skimp on our time together. Resist the glamour of tasks waiting to be done. You have chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from us. Refresh ourselves in the peace of His presence. This peace can be our portion at all times and in all circumstances. Let's learn to hide in the secret of God's presence, even as we carry out our duties in the world. God says, I am both with you and within you. He goes before us to open up the way, and He also walked alongside us. There could never be another companion as devoted as God, because God is our constant companion. There should be a lightness to our step that is observable to others. Do not be weighed down with problems and unresolved issues, for God carry our burden. In the world, we have trials and distress, but don't let them get us down. God says, I have conquered the world and deprived it of power to harm you. In God, we may have confident peace. God wants us to learn a new habit. Try saying I trust you, Jesus. In response to whatever happens to us, if there is time, think about who God is in all His power and glory. Ponder also the depth and the breadth of His love for us. This simple practice will help us to see Him in every situation. Acknowledge God's sovereign control over the universe. When we view events from this perspective, through the light of God's universal presence,
our continual loses assertion its grip of on trusting us. Him with strengthening our relationship become growth as opportunities
when we affirm our trust in God, no matter what. We receive blessings gratefully, realizing they flow directly from the hands of God of grace. Our continual assertion of trusting God will strengthen our relationship and keep us close to God. We can achieve the victorious life through living in deep dependence on God. People usually associate victory with success, not falling or stumbling, not making mistakes, but those who are successful in their own strength tend to go their own way, forgetting about God. It is through problems and failure, weakness and neediness, that we learn to rely on God.